construction of Trail End was finished in 1913, but as you can see from these early photographs, the shades were not immediately installed. The first time the canvas shades appear in any photograph is 1918.
Notice the black lines painted on the canvases. These photos, taken between 1918 and 1935, show glimpses of the original pattern, which was replicated on the current shades.
You may have noticed that there used to be three shades on the porch. While the hardware for it is still mounted, we no longer use the center shade.
These shades are extremely useful in blocking the hot morning sun in the summer, as the sun rises on the eastern side of the mansion. By blocking the sun, the foyer stays a little cooler.
But after 50 years of use, the cotton canvases are starting to wear. The shades are raised using a set of ropes and pulleys. The rope has rubbed holes on the fabric near the top.
Because Sheridan Tent and Awning is the company that not only originally made the shades, but also made these reproductions, we called them to see about repairing the holes.
Don Gould, the owner of Sheridan Tent and Awning, brought the shades down to his shop. The next day, we went down and visited while he explained the history of the business and process for the repairs.
Can you tell us what year Sheridan Tent and Awning was founded?
It was founded in 1909 by the Lauterbach family, who still has the name around here in a law firm and such. It was purchased around 1924 by the Estes family, who owned it then until 2010 when I bought it. We're the third family to have owned it.
So what kind of items do you make here?
We still make tents and awnings, like our name suggests. We also do bags. We make industrial things for like coal mines and for construction companies. We also do some oil and gas work, and we do repairs and small projects that people around town would like.
How many employees do you have at the shop, and what do they do?
I have three employees and myself, and two of them and myself are sewers, and I have one administrative person who watches the front and kind of keeps track of the orders and things like that.
How could you tell when these shades were made?
There's several things about them. So, the main thing, canvas isn't the best outdoor fabric for this sort of application. So back in the old days, that's all they had, though, so that's what they used. There probably was an original set that were made for this back when the mansion was first built. These are most likely replacements for those, though. And the way I can tell is the width of this double stitch seam here. This was made on a machine that we still use, which is over there. And it's a little bit wider than the older machines. We have some older machines that are no longer operable, but they're probably an eighth of an inch narrower in their stitching. And after seeing it a few times, I've learned to be able to recognize that right away. So this one tells me that these were made no earlier than the 1950s, which is when the machine was acquired for talking with the former owner.
What material are they made from?
They're made from what's called a double fill cotton duck, or a numbered duck, which is what we make all our tents out of still. So it's 100% cotton.
What material are you using to make the repairs?
We'll use the same material. We talked about maybe using some more modern materials, but we decided that it wasn't going to match well. And there is a pattern on these, and in order to get that pattern to look as close as we can, we need to probably use the same material when we repaint it.
What are the steps to fix these shades?
The first step is obviously to take them down and then assess them. We've kind of felt the material to see how strong it is. It is getting pretty weak and worn. So what we're going to do is we're going to take a patch of new material and try laying it on the machine. We'll cut the patch to size a little bit bigger, and then we'll try sewing it on there. And we're going to sew it on the outside, actually, because that's where the rubbing is coming from. And that will hopefully keep them going for a few more years. Like I said, I can tell by the width of this that it came from a machine that was purchased in the 1950s. The older machines that they had a much narrower width here, and you can't adjust that width. It's set that way in the factory. So one of the other things about this is this blue line here. You know, that's was from canvas that was made up until about the 1970s, maybe, American-made canvas, which there is no such thing anymore. All our canvas now is made in either Pakistan or India. There's nobody that makes this kind of canvas in the United States anymore. Other things, like this is some pretty old hardware here. We were noticing some, like one of the pulleys doesn't work very well anymore, but I'm pretty sure we can't get those off. The way this was put on is pretty interesting. I'd never seen that before, but that's all hand-stitched on there. And it's got some pretty interesting knots to hold that ring that the rope ties off to. And a lot of this is due to the way that it's mounted in there. It's kind of got a different, older mounting bracket system. The other thing I noticed, and another reason we don't want to take it off, is nowadays we use a clamp that holds the fabric and the rod at the same time. This doesn't have that, so this rod would tend to want to slip. So what they'd done is drilled a hole through the rod at the top and then used a wire to hold that so that rod doesn't slip back and forth. Because these things just hang off of hooks, as we saw when we took it down there. We probably can't replace any of this hardware. I'm pretty sure we would break that if we tried to pry it open and put a new pulley on there. So we're stuck with what we've got. Can't tell whether this was ink or paint originally. We do still paint, like on our awning out front. If you noticed, it has lettering on it, and we actually use house paint and stencils to do that. On our tents, we use what's called an ink stencil, and I can grab one of those real quick. So whenever we make a tent, when we're done with it, we put one of these on top. And then we have an ink brush that we brush on, and that's kind of our brand, our label, so to speak. This could have been done with that. I'm thinking it probably was paint, but I think if we're able to successfully repair it, I would probably mask this off and use the ink brush because it's going to look more like this. It won't stand out as much. If we put new paint on it, there's going to be a big, really bright black spot there. Yeah. So this could have been done that way, but I suspect it probably just, based on how well it's held up, I think it probably was paint. But to get it to match, we'll use the ink. Fold these cut edges under a little bit because they're going to fray if we don't. I'm just going to try to line them up as best I can with my marks and try to make it look fairly straight on there. Since this fabric is so old and fragile, we're going to go super slow with it. I just tore it there. Just what's trying that? To move it up, pushed it, yeah. And it tore.
Okay.
So I don't know, you guys maybe decide what you want to do. I think we're gonna have problems like that.
Ultimately, the shades were too old and the material too fragile to be repaired, which is a possibility that we were cautioned about ahead of time. As soon as the patch was being sewn on, the material ripped, so the repairs were immediately stopped.
We are now taking this opportunity to have the shades reproduced in a more durable acrylic fabric. The new material looks like the cotton canvas that was originally used, but has a longer lifespan and will hold up better to the elements.
Like the shades made in the 19-teens and the 1960s, these new reproductions will still feature the same geometric design. Big thanks to Sheridan Tent and Awning for keeping us supplied with porch shades for over 100 years.
Sweet canvas shades!